Hashem originally thought that the world would always run within, Bereshis Bara Elokim, that it would run, operate within. Hashem saw that the world couldn't exist because there were humans, so Hashem made a partnership. And the Pasuk says later, B'yayim B'ray Hashem Elokim Eretz Hashemayim. You see the two names later in Bereshis together. So that's right. Ad Kan Rashi, that's what Rashi says. So the Sfas Emes says, like, he doesn't use these words, but in the vernacular, he would say, Hashem changes his mind. Like, how exactly does that work? What does it mean exactly that that there was a change in something? And he says, like, he's searching, the Sfas Emes was searching for a deeper meaning. So he says something that I always find so meaningful whenever I think about it or learn it. And he says that when you're planning a bar mitzvah or you're planning a new kitchen or you're planning, you're planning a weekend, you're planning Pesach. So you have a plan. You sit down and you try to work it out and you say, you know, we're gonna serve these things on these days or we're gonna spend chalamoid doing these couple of things with the kids. So you try to plan for things. Now, at the moment that you make that plan, you know it's not going to be the way you think it's going to be. If I ask you, do you really expect you have all these meals laid up, you know, laid out for Yontif and what you're serving it? Do you expect it to go exactly like this? You say, well, I'll probably wing it. Some more people will come, less people will come. Some of the food might get spoiled. So you wind up changing it. But imagine what it would look like if you had no plan. Imagine what it would look like if you started a kitchen with no plan. So you plan for perfection and you adjust to reality. So he says, Hashem didn't change his mind. Again, a different interpretation from Rashi. He says, Hashem didn't change his mind. What happened was that Hashem planned for perfection. Hashem had an image in his mind of what he wanted humans to look like. A human who serves like HaKadosh Baruch Hu, who's spiritual and kind and compassionate. And that was the plan. And Hashem knew that he's creating humans. It's not going to look like this. So Bereshis Bara, the Bria, when he created it, it was perfection. But knowing all along that he would have to change later. And I think that's really the when we talk about our Shabbos meals and we talk about our plans for Chagim, for Yom Tov, I think it's such an important thing to keep in mind. You have a plan for how you'd like it to look. This is, I want my table, you know, Shabbos table to be places, you know, with his mirrors and his Divrei Torah. And the children can all have one conversation, right? And my kids won't pick up something that the teacher's going to say is inappropriate from the older kids. But you know that this is, you know all along that it's not going to. So when we make adjustments, here's my takeaway from the Sfas Emes. When we make adjustments for the inevitable, we shouldn't be frustrated that we're not achieving perfection, because this world is not about perfection.